guys, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my February favorite. So these are 9 beauty products that I have been loving in the month of February, as well as one kind of lifestyle still on the cusp of beauty favorites. So I hope you enjoy and let's get into it. One thing I have really been loving this month that I just recently discovered at Ulta are these Ulta Beauty 50 Premium Quilted Oval Cotton Pads. They look like this, and the best thing about these is they're just giant, and I think that's one of the reasons why I love them. So I will show you. And this comes with 50, by the way, and this was, I'll put down in the description box. I don't remember how much it was, but it was definitely, you know, under $5. So this is like a normal cotton round, and this is the giant oval. One thing I love about these is it's just so easy to like put micellar water or whatever I use when I just don't want to, you know, do the 10-step routine at night, because I have those days, and I'm sure a lot of us do. And I like to have these on hand because it's just so easy to kind of get the contours of my face, especially because it's oval versus the round. It's really easy to, you know, get under the eyes very gently, around the contour of my chin. And yeah, I can use one of these for like my entire face, and they are awesome. So if you haven't tried these kind of cotton rounds, definitely check them out. It's been making my life so much easier. And another thing I want to talk about that's kind of like what I've been using in combination with that, that's a favorite this month, is the La Roche Posay Micellar Water. And this is their Micellar Ultra. It's their cleansing makeup removing water that's soothing. And what I love about this is it just works so effortlessly, and it does the work for me without having to tug and pull, especially with the micellar water. That's really important to me, that it just removes all the makeup and it doesn't leave my skin feeling dry or too oily or irritated. This one just leaves it perfectly balanced, and I love the scent of it. It's kind of like a, it kind of reminds me of, I don't know, I think kind of like peachy or like coconuts or something. I'd say if you've used Bioderma, I would say this is the closest formula I've found to Bioderma. I don't know if that's because they're both made in France, or, you know, that's just their style of micellar waters, but it's definitely worth it. If you see this on sale or even at full price, sometimes they have these like buy one, get one half off at Ulta, things like that. So you can definitely wait for a coupon. It's totally worth it. And this is by La Roche Posay. Oh, and one other thing I wanted to mention with this brand, my husband's mom, so my mother-in-law, she works at a dermatologist office, and I know that she has even given me some things by this brand to try. So, things to be dermatologist approved, of course, consult your own doctor or dermatologist, but it's just an extra perk when, you know, it's something that you see at an actual doctor's office. So yes, I love this. And the next item I want to share is a contour palette. And no, it is not the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, although I love that one. This one comes from the drugstore. It's by Physicians Formula, and it's the Bronze Booster. So although it says bronzer, I totally use this as a contour palette. And I mainly use these two shades here. I don't really touch this one. I guess I could. I'm sure I could use it as a bronzer. I just have other bronzers that I prefer to reach for over this one. But even the palette price, these two shades are worth it for me, especially because I'm so fair. The shade right here just works so perfectly for contouring, whether it be like the hollows of your cheeks, or, you know, the nose, the side of the nose, or if you want to chisel out your chin or whatnot, whatever you're into, I really love this shade. I do find it comparable to the one in the Shade and Light palette, but maybe just a little bit more flattering or a little bit more natural, or the other one can look a little bit too cool toned on me sometimes. And this one works well for setting underneath the eye too. It has a slightly yellow tone, but it's very, very faint. So it's not like a banana powder, because those usually end up being a little bit too yellow underneath my eyes. So this one's like a good balance. So I really, really love this. The only thing I don't like about it is it is a little bulky in my collection, so it does take up some room. And the other thing that I love about it is I actually love the brush that it comes with. And normally I hate brushes that come with these kind of makeup palettes because they're usually pretty bobo. So I don't reach for them at all. But this one I actually do. And I want to say Jessica Braun, Jam Beauty 89, mentioned that she loved this brush too. So I was like, all right, if she loves it, I'm going to try it. So I do like it. And it does seem similar to like the NARS one that everyone uses. And it just fits right here, like really perfectly. If you're trying to do like a nose contour or even like the hollow of your cheek right here, it's just, it blends the powder out beautifully. And it's amazing just for something that comes with a palette. So it's totally worth it. I think this palette is like $5, or I'm sorry, I think this palette is like $15 or something, $14.99, but you can get it on sale. And I did just notice that it does say highlight and contour palette on the back. So yes, it is a highlight and contour palette, and I love it. Okay, the next couple of products I'd like to share with you guys are involving eyes, and the first one is going to be a newer released eyeshadow palette at the drugstore. It's by Milani. It's the Most Love Mattes. So it's right here. You can see it does have my fingerprints all over it. It's a beautiful packaging. It does get dirty with fingerprints easily. It's got a giant mirror in here, and it's got these really, really, really pretty shades, and I'll show you here. But what I love about this palette is it's all matte, which I think is already a challenge to find at the drugstore sometimes. I do love the e.l.f. Mad About Matte. I think a lot of people love that formula, but this one here, I do feel like these are a little bit creamier than those, or those are a little bit more on the drier side. And what's great about these is you can, the way this palette is set up, you can use them, you know, vertically, and they have like a neutrals, a cool tone, and a warm set up here. And I love that it's kind of like an all-in-one matte palette. It's super easy to travel with because of the size, but also the selection. You can really do anything you want to with this palette looks wise. I will say one thing it doesn't have is a matte black. So if that's something that you can't live without in a matte palette, that is one thing you may have to bring or maybe choose another palette. Personally, that is not a drawback or setback for me. I hardly reach for black, I'd have to say. I mean, occasionally I do to deepen up my crease, but because I am very fair, I feel like sometimes it can look too harsh on me, and that's just a personal preference. So it really depends on what, you know, works best for you and your skin tone. So I happen to be loving this. They blend so effortlessly. They are very pigmented, but not to the point where, you know, you're sitting there going blend, blend, blend. So I think it's totally worth it. I found mine at Walmart. It was like $14.99, I want to say. So I think it's an amazing deal for a palette that contains this good of a matte formula at the drugstore. I know a lot of people compare this formula to Tarte or, you know, their matte formula. I would agree it's very similar as far as how it blends and what it looks like on the eye. So definitely a favorite if you can get your hands on this, or, you know, looking for an all matte palette that's not going to break the bank. This is a great one. So keeping on the eye theme, this is another favorite. It is a mascara by L'Oreal. It's the Voluminous Superstar X Fiber Mascara. This is the non-waterproof version, and it comes with two applicators here and two formulas. So the first one is like a primer, and it's black. And I love that the primer portion of this is black, because when ever I use a white primer and put it on my eyelashes, I feel like it can look really chunky, or it can look really, really white. I don't know. And it just doesn't, the mascara on top doesn't always layer the best. So I usually tend to avoid those just because I'm not a fan. But I do really like that this one is a black, black in color. And the second one here has more of a curved brush. It's like kind of rounded, which makes it really easy to kind of get into the, you know, roots of your lashes. And you can see it has a little bit of, you can see the little fibers on it. and I love fiber mascaras. I also love the CoverGirl Supersizer Fiber Mascara, but this one is also a favorite. I think I like this one just as much, and that one has been my favorite for so long. So I totally reach for both. I recommend both. And I'm actually wearing it on my eyelashes today, so I don't have any falsies on or any single lashes, nothing. These are all my lashes with the L'Oreal Superstar Fiber. And what I love about it, oh, and this is in the shade, by the way, before I forget. This is in Blackest Black. But yeah, what I love about it is those fibers just really help fluff out my lashes while the first step just primes them and gets them ready for the fiber. So I really, really love this mascara. I will definitely repurchase this. And yeah, if you haven't tried this one out and you like the CoverGirl Supersizer, give this one a try too. I really like it. It's great. It's amazing. The next product I'm going to talk about, you know what it is, because it has been other YouTubers' favorites probably for a while now, because this product has been out and I finally decided to buy it. I was in the torture chamber of Sephora, and it's a body butter. Can you guess what it is? It is the Sol de Janeiro Brazilian Bum Bum Cream. I wanted to hate you, but I love you. This is a body butter that smells like summer and heaven all in one cream. I absolutely love it. When I get out of the shower and I put this on, it smells up the entire place, like from the front of the house to the back of the house. It's so good, and I absolutely love it. It kind of just reminds me of summer, and I know we're not into spring summer yet, but I live in Florida, so it definitely gets warmer here, and it was giving me summer vibes, so I really wanted to have it. So the claims on this body butter say that it is fast absorbing body cream that helps tighten and smooth like no other. I don't know that I necessarily notice tightening and smoothing, but it definitely is quick drying, and that is a huge plus in what I look for in a body butter, because when I get out of the shower, I want to be able to put on body butter, and then I want to be able to get dressed in the next 5 or 10 minutes for the most part. So I absolutely love this. I highly recommend if you've been on the fence about it. Oh, the hype is real. I love it. All right, and the next thing I want to share is similar to the Bum Bum train, as far as everyone on YouTube, I feel like, has talked about this at some point, or most people, and as far as the beauty community goes, and it is head over heels, like my favorite ride or die lip liner. It's by Charlotte Tilbury. It's the Lip Cheat Reshape and Resize Lip Liner in the shade Pillowtalk. And this shade is just so, so perfect for my lips, especially because my lips are a little bit more pigmented, and it's like the perfect peachy rose nude. I don't know how to describe it exactly, but the formula is beautiful. If you like ColourPop, the formula of ColourPop, or like a creamier lip liner, I typically like creamier lip liners. This one is creamy, and that's probably the closest formula I could compare it to, but it still isn't quite as creamy as that formula, which makes it just perfect, I think, in my book, as far as what I've tried. And I'm actually wearing it today, so you can see a little bit of the outline of it. I didn't really blend it out with the cotton butter or anything, just so you could kind of see on video, but it definitely will help not plump your lips, but will definitely, just like it says, it'll help cheat your lip line. And I think it's beautiful. It looks really natural, especially when blended in a little bit more than what I have on today. But I just kind of wanted to show you that how pigmented it is. I put on a slightly lighter lip on today, so I don't know, it may or may not come off on camera, but it's just gorgeous. It's a beautiful formula. It lasts all day. The inside of my lipstick can wear out, and I'll have like a lip line around my lips depending on what I eat. So it will be there, I promise. It'll be there after you eat. It's such a beautiful formula. And I would love to find a dupe for this. If anyone knows any dupes for this, please let me know in the comments below, because although I love it, it is expensive for a lip liner, or more expensive, I should say. So yes, Charlotte Tilbury, and check this out. It's in Pillowtalk. Okay, moving back to the drugstore, I have a highlighter from Wet n Wild, one of my favorite drugstore brands. This is the Mega Cushion Highlight Illuminator. I think the packaging is so cute. And it comes with this little cushion puff here. As you can see, I use this. I know a lot of people don't like using these little cushion puffs that come in, you know, all cushion foundations and whatnot. But I like them. They're there for a reason, you know. Korean, I think, you know, people in Korean beauty like really knew what they were doing when they designed this little puff. And if you don't like the idea of using these, you can buy, you can, you know, buy reusable ones or buy new ones or disposable, however you want to put it. But they sell them at Sephora, like maybe not this tiny, but they sell like the bigger size ones and whatnot. But anyways, this is what it looks like. It's just a sponge formula and it is just so beautiful. It gives your skin like the perfect lit from within glow. Like this is the most, one of the most natural looking highlights I have. It just makes your skin look really dewy. I just adore this formula. I also love the contour formula as well. I haven't tried any of their color correctors just because that's not something I typically go for, but I am tempted, especially the lilac one. Has anyone tried that one? It's supposed to be more brightening or help brighten your skin. Or if you've tried any of the color correcting ones or if you love or hate, let me know down in the comments below. But yes, I love this. This is in the shade Who's That Pearl. I think that's so cute. The last thing I want to share with you as far as beauty products go today is a nail polish remover. I typically paint my nails myself at home. I rarely get them done at a salon. I might go to the salon two or three times out of the entire year. I kind of want to make it a better habit to go just to like have them shaped or, you know, cleaned up. Sometimes they do a little bit better than what I can do. I do try my best, but you know, I'm still learning. And one thing that's important to me, because I typically have my nails painted all the time, is having a good nail polish remover that's not going to completely strip and, you know, dry out my cuticles. And this is the best one that I found so far. It is by Zoya. It's the 3-in-1 Remove Plus, and it claims to be a polish remover, nail cleaner, and nail prep, and it totally does all of those things. So I think it is just a beautiful formula as far as what it does. It doesn't smell really harsh and aggressive when you take off, you know, your nail polish, so you don't have that, like, I can't breathe in this room feeling. And it is, it's just great. I love that it comes in this little pump cap. You can, you know, keep it closed or unlock it. And it's just so easy. You just put a little cotton pad there, it pumps out, and then I can take like one cotton pad and it'll remove all my nail polish from one hand. Sometimes I can even get over to the next one depending on like what I'm wearing. It does great with glitter. And the other thing that I love about this formula is that it's, although it has acetone in it, it's very mild and it claims to be a mild formula. It's kind of hard to read on the back here, but it says, Zoya Remove does it all. Mild acetone formula moisturizes, nourishes, and helps fortify the nail plate while removing all traces of existing nail lacquer without stripping, streaking, or staining. Use as a nail plate cleaner and prep product prior to applying base coat to dramatically extend color wear. Yes, so I absolutely love this. It does what it claims to do. It's $10 and you can find it at Ulta. Don't forget, you can use a $3.50 off 15 coupon to get this cheaper if you get some, you know, something else like the cotton pads or whatever. That's what I do. But yeah, it is amazing and I love it. I will definitely repurchase when I run out. And the last product I'm going to share with you guys today is non-beauty related as far as like being makeup or skincare or nail care or hair care or any of that. It is actually an earring holder and I will show it to you here. Just going to grab it. So it looks like this and I love this. It holds 30 earrings and I purchased this from the Container Store and guys, this was like $5.99 and I just love it. It, I don't know, it just displays my jewelry so beautifully and I think it is a great alternative to what I was doing before where I kind of just had them all in like a little, you know, jewelry jar that looked pretty. I mean, it looked pretty, but it was like a nightmare trying to go through all my little different studs, especially. So, yes, you can. And what I also love about it is you can display like some of your larger pieces or your hoop earrings, because they give you some room here that's tiered. Another thing you can do is this does come apart, so it just comes in two pieces. So there's really no assembly. You just literally put this in here and bam, earring holder. Makes your, and it looks really sleek on your desk too, because of the acrylic, it doesn't look like it takes up all the space on your desk. And, you know, it really doesn't because it's not that big. As you can see, it's like the size of my head. But yeah, I've been looking for a solution, and I love that this one is an inexpensive one too and still looks very pretty and very chic. So love this earring holder. Okay, guys, I hope you found this video helpful or useful to you. Please leave down in the comments below if you've tried any of these products out, if you love them, if you hated them, if you have any tips for how to use products differently from what I described. I love to know. I love to learn. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe or give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you in my next one. Bye, guys.